Okay. Welcome back. So we proceed to now finding the derivative of the function. So we now find the derivative of the function. We have dy dx being equal to three x squared minus nine. Okay, so having found the derivatives, we can now get the extrema points. So we know that to get these points, the derivative has to be zero, isn't it? So equating dy x to zero gives 3x squared minus 9 being equal to 0. We can factor out a 3, so it was x squared. X squared minus 3 being equal to 0. Dividing by 3 on both sides gives us this being equal to 0. So that x equals plus or minus root 3. So these are the critical points. So we're saying that x is equal to minus root 3 and plus root 3 are the critical points. So we're going to test each of the points so that we see which one will give us a minimum, a maximum, or the point of inflection. So now to do that, let us guess the 2 points. Okay.
There's someone in the waiting room. Someone is complaining in the waiting room. Yes, sir, he's in the waiting room. The guy is complaining.
Okay, let me check. I disabled this.
Tell him to rejoin and then join again. I was also in the team.
Okay.
Like the person joined before the SAS started the meeting, so.
Okay.
Was that?
Yeah, my waiting room is disabled. It's not active.
Okay. Okay, thank you, sir. He has joined. He has managed.
So thank you, sir. We have the critical points, which are negative root 3 and positive root 3. So now, for each point, we can have the 2 point. So x being equal to negative root 3, we can find y. We have y being equal to, when you substitute in the original equation, negative root 3 to the power 3 minus 9 by negative root 3, this gives us positive. gives us positive. Gives us positive root 6 root 3. Okay, that's what we get.
So,
yes, please.
How 6 not 9? Because to be root 3 times root 3 times root 3. So it is okay. Root 3 times root 3, which is 3. 3 times 3, which is 9. Okay, 9 so, supposed to be 9 root 3.
Okay, let's do it together, we see. Tell that one, make a noise to mute yourself for himself. So let's do it together. Since we know that negative root 3 to the power 3 means negative root 3 by negative root 3 by negative root 3, isn't it? So you observe that negative by negative is positive for the first one. It's positive. Eh? Root 3 by root 3 gives us 3, isn't it? Gives us 3. So we have 3 by negative root 3, which gives us negative 3 root 3. Are we able to see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So meaning that we are done for this part. For the first part, we are done. Eh? So let us also try to work on the other part. The other part is in fact negative 9 by negative 3. This gives us what? Positive 9 root 3, isn't it? So now adding the two. Adding the two.
Okay, I see it now.
Okay. So similarly for the other point, for the other critical point, similarly for x being equal to root 3, we have y being equal to negative 6 root 3. So that the full points are negative root 3, comma 9, comma 6. Eh? Comma 6 root 3. And the other one gives us root 3, comma negative 6 root 3. So these are the points that we have, which will determine the maxima, the minima, or the point of inflection. Okay, so let's test each point now. We can opt to use the second derivative test. We use the second derivative. Second derivative test. And this demands us to find the second derivative itself, which is just the derivative of the first, the derivative of the first derivative, right? The first derivative was what? The first derivative was 3x squared minus 9. So we want to differentiate this function with respect to x. We want to differentiate this function with respect to x. No wonder we've written dy dx outside then. Well, dy dx outside, meaning that we're differentiating this function inside the bracket. And these are the brackets. What we have is the first derivative, isn't it? Okay. So this gives us what? 6x. Just 6x. Huh? Okay. So now we test for each point. The second derivative with respect to x, let's pick the first point where x is being equal to negative root 3. So we test negative root 3, comma 6 root 3. What will this give us? Meaning that we substitute for the variables present. Eh? But you observe that here we just have x. Eh? What we have is x. So where there is x, we are going to put negative root 3. So this gives us 6 by negative root 3. It gives us negative 6 root 3. Now this is some number less than 0, isn't it? So if the second derivative is less than 0, it means that point is a maximum point. So we have since the second derivative of f being equal to negative root 3 is less than 0, we have that negative root 3 comma 6 root 3 is a maximum point. Okay, should we go to the next slide? Any question on this one? Okay, let's proceed with this, the other point. For x being equal to root 3, that is to say, we are testing this point. We have the second derivative with respect to x. At that point, giving us what? So we have 6. Then where x is, we substitute root 3, isn't it? Which gives us 6 root 3. And this is positive, isn't it? So since this is positive, we have a minimum point. So we have this root 3 is a minimum point. Okay, so now when the second derivative is 0, it means we have the point of inflection. Eh? So meaning that in this case, the point of inflection can be noticed at 0,0, because the second derivative is 6x, isn't it? Meaning that this can only be 0 if x is 0, isn't it? So the point of inflection will be at 0,0. Note that the second derivative is 6x, which can be 0, when x is equal to 0. So we have 0,0 as the point of inflection. So we can now do the sketch. We Let's do the speech now. I can change the color. So we need to plot the intercepts. Eh? The intercepts that we got were zero. Well, excuse an intercept here. We also have an intercept at negative three, and another intercept is at positive three. So meaning that your curve will pass through these points. Then the maximum is at which point? The maximum is at negative root three, comma. So negative root three, comma, positive six root three. Meaning if this is six root three, so somewhere here, we have a maximum, and then the minimum is at this point. The minimum is at this point, so you can plot this point. Eh? It's positive root 3, comma negative 6 root 3. So the minimum can be somewhere here. Then you can draw a graph. You can draw a graph passing through these turning points that we got. So this is your sketch. All right, unless there are questions, otherwise we can move forward. We'll go to the other one. Any question? Okay, we proceed.
Sir.
Yes, please.
Wait just a minute. Just a concern. For instance, you find this same question on that on functions. It's just general like sketch. Can you use calculus to solve such questions to find the
you can use since in the question the method has not been restricted, so you can still use calculus. So we'll go to the next slide. Okay, so we have y being equal to x to the power 4 minus 6x squared. So this is the function that we have.
That's within campus.
So let's get the intercepts.
Okay.
We first find.
Okay, I can. Okay.
The intercepts. So on the intercepts, we have the x-intercepts. We know that to find the x-intercepts, we have y is equal to zero, isn't it?
Yeah, then I can find the placement.
Oh. So since y is equal to zero, so we get x power 4 minus 6 x squared being equal to 0, of which you can factor out x squared. So that you have x squared minus 6 being equal to 0, which is a product of the two factors, meaning that each of these is equal to 0. So the product should be 0. So we have x being equal to zero, x squared minus six being equal to zero. So that x is zero. Root of this six, a negative root of six. So those are the x intercepts. Y intercept. Y intercept, you know that x is zero. Of x being equal to zero. So substituting. So that y is equal to zero. So we are done with the intercepts. We can now move to the next stage, finding the derivative of the function. We now find the derivative. So dy, dx, we are differentiating this function, x to the 4 minus 6 x squared with respect to x. We have 4x to the power 3 minus 4x. Okay, in case you have forgotten how to differentiate, the power must drop to multiply the original function. Then when this power drops, as in this case, you subtract a 1 from the power 1. That's how we differentiate. Eh? Okay, I believe this is clear for everyone. Eh? So this is the derivative we're getting. So we now find the critical point. Let me find the derivative. To find the critical points, we equate the derivative to zero. We find the critical points, that is dy, x being equal to zero. So we have 4x to the power 3 minus 12x being equal to zero. Factoring out x, we get, in fact, we can factor out 4x. Eh? 4x is a common factor, so that remain with x squared minus 3. X squared minus 3 being equal to 0. In which case, we get x is equal to 0, or x squared minus 3 being equal to 0, so that x is equal to 0. X is equal to negative root 3 and x is equal to positive root 3. So these are the critical values. So for these critical values, we can find the full coordinate. So for x being equal to 0, we have y being equal to, we substitute 0 in the original function. So we have 0 power 4 minus 6, 0 power 2, which gives us 0. So that the full point is now 0, 0.
So you have addressed to help this guy later.
Okay. So for the other point, x being equal to negative root 3, what is y? Y will be equal to negative root 3 to the 4 minus 6, negative root 3 to the power 2. And this gives us This gives us negative 9. So that the full point is now negative 3 comma negative 9. Also for the other point, the last one, for x being equal to root 3, we go to y being equal to root 3 to the 4. Root 3 to the 4 minus 6, root 3 to the 2. And now this gives us 24. So that the full point is root 3 comma 24. So now these are the critical points that we have. There are three of them. So this is the first one, this is the second one, and this is the third one. So we're not going to use the second derivative test to test each of these so that we are certain whether it is the maximum, minimum, or rather the point of inflection. So these points are the turning points, isn't it? Okay. So by second derivative test.
Sam.
Yes, please.
Bring back the previous board.
Okay.
Yeah, explain how you've gotten the 24, not getting the 24.
Okay, let's discuss it together. So, we're just making some substitutions. Let's simplify this part and that part. Here it is root 3 to the power 4. So we begin with that. Root 3. I don't know whether you're comfortable with this color that I've used.
I am.
Okay, to the power of 4 implies the root of 3 squared multiplied by the root of 3 squared. You know that root 3 squared is simply 3, isn't it? So we've got 3 by 3, which gives us a 9. Okay. So this is giving us a 9. Then we go to the other one. This is giving us negative 6 by root of 3 squared. This is giving us what? Negative 18. Negative 6 root 3 squared gives us 3. So this is giving us negative 18. Negative 18.
If we simplify negative 9 again.
Okay, so
it will be one and the same.
So it will be one and the same, eh? Okay, thank you.
Yes.
So this part. We're saying it will be the same point, eh? It will be negative 9 again. Okay. Okay, we do the testing now. So we are testing at positive 3, root 3, and post negative root 3. So let's do the testing. So we have dy, the second derivative being equal to, let me just rewrite it. Did we differentiate? Define the second derivative. Did we get this one together? Did we? Okay, we proceed. So now we test at each point. The second derivative.
No, that's not the Sir.
Yes, please.
I think that not that one. We found 4x to the power 3 minus 12x.
Okay, so, oh, wonderful.
Yeah, we didn't differentiate going to the second derivative.
Oh, we didn't get the second derivative, no wonder.
Yes.
I see. And so, okay, so let's now differentiate. Let's differentiate. Since dy dx was found to be 4x by 3 minus 12x, eh? Isn't it? So the second derivative would be equal to, we differentiate this function 4x to the 3 minus 12 with respect to x. This gives us 12x squared minus 12, isn't it? Okay, so this is the second derivative. So we test for each point. For x, the critical points are, we have 0. What do we get when x is 0? We've got the second derivative at x is equal to 0, being equal to what? Negative 12, eh? Being equal to negative 12, which is less than 0. So we have a minimum point. Thus, x is equal to 0. At x is equal to 0, we've got a minimum point. Eh? A maximum point, eh? Because we're using the second derivative this time. When you're using the first derivative, that becomes a minimum. But when you're using the second derivative test, it is opposite. Eh? Okay.
So why is opposite? What?
Yes, please.
So I was saying that when you're using the
when you use the second derivative, and the second derivative, you find that it is negative, it is less than zero. It means at such a point, you've got a maximum point. But when you're using the first derivative, it's the other way around. You get the point, eh?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, sir, I've got a question.
Yes, please.
How do you find the point of inflection using first derivative test?
Using the first derivative?
Yeah.
Okay, so when you're using the first derivative, finding the point of inflection, it is still the same where the derivative is zero. It remains the same, right? Where the first derivative is zero, that's the point of inflection. Okay, so we have 0, 0 is a maximum point, eh? Maximum point. So you can do the testing for the other one also. For x is equal to, what was the other critical value? -√3. You have the second derivative at this point, at x being equal to -√3. When you make substitutions in the second derivative function that we have, we get, when you put √3 here, it's 12 by 3, which is 36, so it's, we get 24, right? We get 24, which is positive. And so this point, -√3, -9 is a minimum point. Is a minimum point. Then the last point is what? +√3 for x being equal to √3. We have the second derivative with respect to x at x being equal to root 3, being equal to, when you make substitutions, I want to find the other point. So when you substitute root 3, what do you get? You still get 24, isn't it? You still get 24. So that the point root 3 comma negative 9 is a minimum point. Is a minimum point. Okay. So now what next? The next thing is the sketch. Eh? We've gotten the critical points. We've gotten the intercepts. So this is all we need for us to do the sketch. So in this graph, in this function, we do not have a situation where the derivative is zero, isn't it? So it implies we do not have the point of inflection. So we can now do the sketch. We can now do the sketch. Show the intercept. We are down at zero. We are down at root 3. So we negative root 6. We also are down at positive root 6. Then the turning points we've got two. One is still at zero. Like there are three, one is at zero. The other one is at negative root 3 comma negative 9, which can be somewhere here. The other one is also at positive root 3 comma 9, which is somewhere here. You know, this is negative 9. And so we can plot these points. We can join. So we've got a graph passing through this point. So we've got a graph, turning, then it passes through this point, the 0, 0, and then it comes, passes through this point and connects to the other point. So this is how your sketch will look like. Okay, any more questions? So the last
question. I have a good question, sir.
Yes, please.
So when finding the x-intercept, do we use the original function or maybe we use the first derivative or second derivative when finding the x-intercept?
Okay, all the intercepts are found using the original function.
Sorry? When
all the intercepts, whether the x-intercept, whether it is the y-intercept, you find them using the original function. Because if you use the derivative, you know,